The Battle of Waterloo, which took place in Belgium on June 18, 1815, marked the final defeat of Napoleon Bonaparte, who conquered much of Europe in the early 19th century. Napoleon rose through the ranks of the French army during the French Revolution, seized control of the French government in 1799 and became emperor in 1804. Through a series of wars, he expanded his empire across Western and Central Europe. The Battle of Waterloo, in which Napoleon's forces were defeated by the British and Prussians, marked the end of his reign and of France's domination in Europe. Many paintings of the Battle of Waterloo were to be remarkably successful. Today I bring 10 top iconic paintings of the Battle of Waterloo. Before we start, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications now so you won't miss any of our new videos. 1. The Battle of Waterloo. The Battle of Waterloo is an oil on canvas by William Sadler II made in June 1815. It depicts the Battle of Waterloo under the command of Napoleon Bonaparte against English forces under the Duke of Wellington, the Prussian troops under Gebhard Lebrecht von Blücher, and soldiers from the Netherlands, the province of Hanover, the Duchy of Nassau and the Principality of Brunswick-Wolfenbüttel. William Sadler II was the son of the portrait painter and engraver William Sadler. Two of his sons became painters, the eldest being William Sadler III. The numbers after each name are merely used to distinguish one from another. Sadler lived at a number of different addresses before settling in Manders Building, Ranelagh, where he died in December 1839. 2. The Storming of L.A. Hay St. Richard Notel, January 12, 1857 to April 26, 1914, was a German artist and pioneer of the study of military uniforms. The Storming of La Haye Sainte, the crucial position at the center of Wellington's position at the Battle of Waterloo. Notel was born in Glogau in 1857. His father, August Notel, was an art teacher and gave him lessons in drawing and painting from an early age. In this time, Notel developed an interest in military fashion and history. By late adolescence, he was already employed as an illustrator for the graphics-based newspaper, Illustriert Zeitung, as well as for postcards and magazines. In 1880, with an established reputation, Notel was entered into the Berlin Academy of Fine Arts. 3. La Bataille de Waterloo. La Bataille de Waterloo. 18 June 1815. The Battle of Waterloo was fought on Sunday, the 18th of June 1815 near Waterloo in Belgium, part of the United Kingdom of the Netherlands at the time. Claimant Auguste Andrew was a French artist and illustrator. In 1870 Andrew worked for Le Monde Illustré during the Franco-Prussian War. 4. Charge of the French CUIRASSIERS at Waterloo. Henry Félix Emmanuel Philipoteau. The Battle of Waterloo, the British squares receiving the charge of the French cuirassiers, is an 1874 oil painting. It is thought that the painting was bought by Francis Rubel Bryan in around 1875, he donated it to the Victoria and Albert Museum in 1880. Henry Félix Emmanuel Philipoteau was a French artist. He was born in Paris, France, studied art at the studio of Léon Cogniet, and first exhibited his work at the Paris Salon of 1833. 5. The Storming of Planchenoit. Ludwig Elsholtz Erstürmung von Planchenoit. Painting about the Battle of Waterloo about the same time, the Prussian 5th, 14th, and 16th Brigades were starting to push through Planchenoit, in the third assault of the day. The church was by now on fire, while its graveyard, the French center of resistance, had corpses strewn about, as if by a whirlwind. Ludwig Elsholtz, 1805-1850, a German painter of genre subjects and battles, born at Berlin, studied in the academy of his native city, and afterward in the studio of Franz Kruger, the painter of horses. His best work is the Battle of Leipzig, painted in 1833, and now in the possession of the German emperor. He died at Berlin in 1850. In the Berlin National Gallery is the beginning of the fight, dated 1834. 6. Marechal Ney at Waterloo. Louis-Jules Dumoulin. Marshal Ney and his staff leading the cavalry charge at Waterloo. Marshal of the Empire Michel Ney, 1st Duke of Elchingen, 1st Prince of the Moskva. Ney was promoted to General de Brigade in August 1796, and commanded cavalry on the German fronts, on 17 April 1797. The action earned Ney criticism, and some argue that it led to Napoleon's defeat at Waterloo. Louis-Jules Dumoulin, Paris, 1860-1924, was a French artist and painter. He traveled in East Asia and was the founder of the Société Coloniale des Artistes Français in 1908. Dumoulin is an Orientalist painter linked to the official artistic circles and a great traveler from the various missions that will be entrusted to him. He made his first major trip outside Europe in 1888 on the occasion of an official mission to Japan ordered by the Ministry of Education. In 1908 he co-founded the Colonial Society of French Artists and was its president until his death in 1924. 7 Battle de Mont Saint-Jean. Dite de Watterloo, le 18 juin 1815. Charles Horace Vinet and Jacques-François Swebarc. Battle of Mont Saint-Jean. Battle of Mont Saint-Jean or the Battle of Waterloo, colored litho by Antoine Charles Horace Vinet, called Carl Vinet, 1758-1836, and Jacques-François Swebarc, 1769-1823. Napoleon's seemingly dismissive remark may have been strategic, given his maxim, in war, morale is everything. He had acted similarly in the past, and on the morning of the Battle of Waterloo may have been responding to the pessimism and objections of his chief of staff and senior generals. Disestimating Marshal Ney on that morning. Napoleon said, "Just because you have all been beaten by Wellington, you think he's a good general. I tell you Wellington is a bad general, the English are bad troops, and this affair is nothing more than eating breakfast." 8 Place Neuwirth, Anglesey, Waterloo. Dennis Dighton. More than 20 years of warfare had eroded the numbers of suitable cavalry mounts available on the European continent. This resulted in the British heavy cavalry entering the 1815 campaign with the finest horses of any contemporary cavalry arm. British cavalry troopers also received excellent mounted swordsmanship training. They were, however, inferior to the French in maneuvering in large formations, cavalier in attitude, and unlike the infantry, some units had scant experience of warfare. Dennis Dighton was the son of the caricaturist Robert Dighton and a younger brother was Richard Dighton. He enrolled as a student at the Royal Academy in 1807 and exhibited 17 pictures there between 1811 and 1825. He enjoyed the patronage of the Prince of Wales, who had been a close friend of his mother. Through the influence of the prince, he received a commission in the army in 1811, however, he soon returned to civilian life. By 1814 he had received the title of military painter to HRH the Prince Regent. The prince sent Dighton to the southern Netherlands just before the Battle of Waterloo and seems to have bought all his exhibited pictures. Dighton visited the Waterloo battlefield 5 days after the victory and executed 9 paintings of the battle. 9 Prussian attack Plancenoit. Adolf Northern. Prussian attack at Planchenoit, showing the Prussian divisions of Hiller, Rissel, and Tippelskirch defeating the French Imperial Young Guard, 1st Battalions of the 2nd Grenadiers and 2nd Chasseurs at the Battle of Waterloo. Adolf Northern, also credited as Adolf Northern or Adolf Northern, the 6th of November 1828 to the 28th of May 1876, was a German painter. He was born in Munden, Kingdom of Hanover and was a member of Dusseldorf School of Painting. Chiefly depicting battle scenes and particular events of the Napoleonic Wars, Northern's most noted works including this one, Napoleon's Retreat from Russia, which depicts the failure of the 1812 invasion of Russia by Napoleon. Northern died in Dusseldorf at aged 48. 10 Scotland Forever. Elizabeth Thompson. Our officers of cavalry have acquired a trick of galloping at everything. Wellington. Elizabeth Southerton Thompson, Lady Butler, the 3rd of November 1846 to the 2nd of October 1933, was a British painter, and specialized in painting scenes from British military campaigns and battles, including the Crimean War and the Battle of Waterloo. The roll call, purchased by Queen Victoria, the Defence of Rorke's Drift, and Scotland Forever, showing the Scots Greys at the Battle of Waterloo, Leeds Art Gallery, are among her notable works. She wrote about her military paintings in an autobiography published in 1922, "I never painted for the glory of war, but to portray its pathos and heroism." She married Lieutenant General Sir William Butler, becoming Lady Butler. The Battle of Waterloo was fought on Sunday, the 18th of June 1815 near Waterloo in Belgium, part of the United Kingdom of the Netherlands at the time. A French army under the command of Napoleon Bonaparte was defeated by two of the armies of the 7th Coalition, an army consisting of units from the United Kingdom, the German Legion, the Netherlands, Hanover, Brunswick, and Nassau, under the command of the Duke of Wellington, referred to by many authors as the Anglo-Allied Army, and a Prussian army under the command of Field Marshal Blücher. According to Wellington, though they were superior individual horsemen, they were inflexible and lacked tactical ability. I considered one squadron a match for two French. I didn't like to see four British opposed to four French, and as the numbers increased and order, of course, became more necessary, I was the more unwilling to risk our men without having a superiority in numbers. The battle marked the end of the Napoleonic Wars. Many top general was involved in the Battle of Waterloo, but that is another history for another time. Before we finish, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications so you won't miss any of our new videos.